you can feel it. It's not like a thing anybody can really notice. It's the feeling that you have inside yourself when you hear that one song. Maybe it's that release. When you start to flow, it's just everything works like clockwork. And you know where the staff is going to land, and you know how it's going to spin. But I think it takes a lot of people a long time to realize what exactly a flow is. But flow comes from the heart. I've been spinning fire since November of 2016. I've always had an obsession with fire. I think most people do. It's like the most overwhelming feeling to have when you first light it and you realize that you can control something that's above you. Because if you think of fire, you think of destruction, you think of flames, you think of broken families and everything gone in an instant. But to have that control over that fire and to know where it's going and to be able to light it and put it out and handle it and transfer it, it's a very accomplished feeling. It's like you're above something that you thought was above you. I grew up in a Native American background, so everything that we did was based on the earth. It was actually something that was bestowed upon me from my parents. They taught me to try to release things in different ways other than anger or getting emotional, to try to just let it go up in flames so you didn't have to carry it anymore.
My name's Greg. I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee. I'm 31 years old, and I've been performing with fire for about 13 years now, since I turned 18. I want to say it was my very first night out clubbing, and I saw people playing with glow sticks. I thought, geez, that looks like fun. So somebody actually had a spare glow stick, and I had a string, and I tied a string to a glow stick, and all I was doing was spinning this glow stick around. This guy walked up in front of me and crossed his arms and stared at me, watching me do my little thing with my glow stick. And as soon as I dropped it, he whipped out these two LEDs on strings and started weaving a very complicated pattern in the air in front of me. And I don't know if he had good intentions or if it was just competitive bravado, but that actually motivated me to learn how to do it.
I think what started off me wanting to spin fire was we started a fire event here once a month at Bar Marley. All the sales and proceeds for the night went to benefit the families that lost homes in the fire of Gatlinburg. And a girl came to me and asked me if I would want to learn how to spin fire. I thought it sounded like a great release, so we started there. It was in November of 2016 that I started.
I would say that you can tell how much a person really loves doing object manipulation by how good they are at it, because it's really a matter of how much you love it, how much effort you put into it, how much time you put into it, and what you get back out of that.
Everybody's really supportive. There's lots of different fire toys and different ways to go about learning, but every single person in the community wants to reach out and help you learn or help you establish where you want to be in the community. It's like one big family that likes to play with fire.
I think I saw that there was a need in the community for a group, a place for people to come to practice their flow art and hopefully do so in a way that's like healthy and encouraging and non-competitive and just a place for us to just kind of come be ourselves.
We're a group that accepts everyone and sees the creativity and the good in everyone, and try to do nothing but enjoy ourselves and spread a positive message. It'll be 5 years that I've been clean in October, and this is like the one event that has kept me that way.
My husband and I stopped drinking about a year and a half ago, and I kept thinking, like, what if there are other people in the community that want a safe place to come where there's not going to be that kind of alcohol, you know, encouraging, you know, that kind of toxic thing. And if maybe they want to come off of alcohol or they want to come off of opiates, or maybe they're pulling away from that music festival scene, which is very heavily, you know, rampant with drug use.
When I came out of rehab, I had a pretty bad opiate problem, and sobriety was very difficult for me because I had all this anger and emotion kept up inside of me, and I had no way to let it out because I don't talk about my feelings. When I found hooping, that was like my way to express myself, and so I used that as my outlet to any time I had a craving or any time I felt like I was going to make a bad decision, I picked up my hoop. I picked up my hoop and I flowed and hooped it out until I couldn't hoop anymore and I had no energy left to do anything. And honestly, that has probably been something that helped save my life.
We have fire fans, we have fire poi, you have dragon staff, you have helio staff. Basically anything you want to do with fire, they make a prop for it. I use a dragon staff. It's your basic staff. It's about 5 feet long. I've got one of the lighter ones. They make them in all different weights, but they're fully weighted. So if you hold it in the center, it won't tip on either side. It'll just stay level. It's got 5 wicks, one on each of the ends, and then 4 that spin around it. And then you just light them all at the same time.
I do poi specifically, which is objects on a string or chain. You hold one end of the string in each hand and you spin them around in patterns around your body.
To me, it's really a release, but the number one thing I could tell anyone that wants to get into fire spinning is safety first. You want to have your fire blanket. You want to make sure that someone's safetying for you. You want to make sure that you fuel up and spin off in different spots from where you're going to light, or you can set the whole beach on fire.
How did that happen?
The one night I didn't come here, people were drunk and being stupid.
Oh, yeah.
Somebody set the whole beach on fire.
Fuel got spilled, he dropped the staff, whole beach went up in flames.
I had a mentor, he was very adamant about fire safety. He taught me all the things to be aware of, he taught me the proper procedures to take whenever you do perform.
You will catch yourself on fire, you will burn yourself, you could hurt someone else. The fire always controls you. You move around the fire. So the number one important thing that I could tell anyone that wants to get into fire learning is safety. Just 100% safety. Because it's not a game. Yes, it's fun. Yes, it's exciting. It's kind of scary, but it's definitely not a game.
It forces you to focus 100% on the flames, on the fire, on the object you're manipulating. Nothing else exists. For the few minutes that those balls of Kevlar or Kevlar wicks are burning, the world gets much simpler.
You really don't recognize anyone besides you in the fire. You can hear people cheering, you can see them, you know, but you don't really recognize that you're being put on a display, because the whole purpose of learning fire is for yourself. So no, when I'm on stage, the only thing that exists is me and the fire, and everything else is non-existent.
I've been gazing at the stars for a minute. I never could connect the constellations, but I really like the way they all kind of shimmer. City light pollution symptom for the falls. Now I'm waiting. And black holes strip space walls. Then the matrix leaves me an enigma. Food for thought. I'm the top chef. Out of the box, lost profit. Speak to the cosmos before thoughts process.
Yeah.
state. Super beings sign the trees of the lands in space. See the sharks in the distance, watch me swim in their direction. Archbishop of the new world, curled in the mess, found pearls in the wreckage. Ponder, spawned 1,000 ships to arm the armada. Garments, harm, posture, slate, onyx and jade. Weapons in cold, breastplate, blessed with the crest made of thin gold.